For more than a decade, Game and Fish Department biologists have been trapping and banding mourning doves in July.
We're just doing our annual dove banding operation in the state of North Dakota. You know, every state in the central management unit is kind of responsible for banding a quota, a certain amount of birds every year.
The goal this year is to band around 1,500 doves in North Dakota. The band returns from hunters play a key role in managing the population and helps agencies like Game and Fish set season lengths and bag limits.
The harvest and return information we get from the banding data kind of goes into a model and allows us to predict some of that information. So we really use it to, you know, monitor total abundance of the population and how our harvest is affecting the population overall.
Dingus says the North American mourning dove population is doing well and good hunting is available nationwide. However, the number of hunters in North Dakota has declined in the last few decades.
In the early 80s, we had over 20,000 dove hunters, and currently we have about 7,000 to 8,000 hunters annually.
Dingus and his crews started pre-baiting banding sites in the middle of June, and then a couple of weeks later incorporated the traps. Doves are ground walkers and like open habitat, so the traps are strategically placed in open areas that are also near good nesting and roosting habitat. The doves walk through the wired funnel opening on the traps and can't get out until released by biologists.
When we approach the trap, I mean, we try to get the bird out as fast as possible. We're taking information such as sex and age on the bird, and then we just put a band on it and release it.
If you're out dove hunting this fall and harvest a bird with a small metal band, go to www.reportband.gov to report the band. This is Tom Jensen, Outdoors.